student.
And all those virgins arose, and the foolish said to the wise, "Give us of your oil, for our lamps have gone out."
But the wise answered, saying also, "Lest there be not enough for us and us, but pray you rather to them themselves and buy for yourselves."
And while they were to buy, the bridegroom came, and they that were ready went in into the marriage, and the door was shut.
Afterward came also other virgins, saying, "Lord, Lord, open to us." And he said to them, "I know you not.
Watch therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour wherein the Son of Man cometh."
Nestled in a grove of trees, at the top of a steep hill, there was a shop. And every person who toiled up the path to the shop came for the same reason, to buy oil. The shopkeeper was a young man with thick brown hair. His large hands were strong but gentle. He spent much of his time sitting in a wooden workbench, carefully sculpting small oil-burning lamps. It was his tradition to give one of these lamps to every person who moved into the village. Each lamp was meticulously crafted, and each was different from the others. Some were round, others were oval. Some were made of ordinary clays, and others were made of terracotta. Some were perfectly smooth, while others had intricate designs tooled into their surfaces. But all of them held oil, and all of them produced light. The shopkeeper carefully sculpted each lamp to complement a quality he hoped each woman would develop within herself. With time and effort, each could become
a woman of the scriptures,
a woman who moves in the spirit,
a woman who keeps the commandments,
a woman who respects sacred things,
a woman of humility,
a woman who is loyal,
a woman of service,
a woman who diligently prepares,
a woman of prayer,
a woman of grace, personal conversion, and holiness.
With her lamp, each woman was given a choice. She could use her gift carelessly, foolishly thinking she had plenty of time to prepare, or she could use her gift at all times and in all things and in all places. The shopkeeper reminded each woman to return to the shop often. The tiny flame the lamp produced could not be maintained without an ongoing supply of oil, and the source came only from the lamp maker's shop. But the path to the top of the hill was steep, and the journey took effort and time. Those seeking oil would arrive at the lamp maker's shop at all times of the day or night, and each woman was met with a warm welcome no matter the hour. The shopkeeper's brown eyes would light up as the landowner came through the door, and he would always set his work aside to visit. Everyone knows his name, the shopkeeper on the hill. All through the night, the light in his window burns as he works the clay, and everyone waits to see the lamp he's designed for her, carefully sculpted, perfectly planned to be just as unique as she, a sculpture of her soul, a vessel carved to hold the oil he freely gives. He seems to look inside each heart and shape a work of art that only he can fill. The shopkeeper on the hill. She knows where she will find the shopkeeper on the hill. Rugged and steep, each step of it worth the climb. Whenever he takes the time, he reminds her to return, so her lamp will always burn with the oil he freely gives. He sings to look inside her bed. He hopes she'll bring the lamp that only he can fill. His door is open still, the shopkeeper on the hill. He waits at the window. One of the first women to receive a lamp from the shopkeeper was Alana.
I use my lamp to light up the shattered corners of my little home. When evening comes, I sit by a soft wall and read my favorite books. Sometimes when I have finished reading, I take my book, set it by the lamp, wrap a warm blanket around my shoulders, and watch the flames flicker and dance. My lamp has seen me through joy and celebration, has given me so much comfort through disappointment and through discouragement. The constant light has guided me through the many hours of darkness. Even though my lamp has been used for many, many years, its light still shines as bright as on the day that was made.
Gave long ago this life.
Shopkeeper worried for Ashira because she was always so rushed and hurried. He watched her run in and out of her house all day long. Half the time, she had to run back to get her shoes. Most of the time, she forgot to take her lamb. He knew of her great responsibility as a teacher, healer, mentor, and caregiver, but he also knew the concerns of her heart.
Most days, it is all I can do to get myself to rest. From the time I get up in the morning, I get right to work. On the one hand, I feel as though I'm everything to everyone. On the other hand, I feel as if I never get anything accomplished. Some days I look up at the shop on the hill and think today will be the day. Between the dishes and the children and the trips to the market and scrubbing the floor, I will find the time.
The shopkeeper would refill the tiny lamps with oil, drop by drop, according to each woman's need. Dina was the first to ask the shopkeeper for a vessel to hold more oil. It seemed that the supply in her lamp was not enough to keep the flame burning between her frequent visits to the shop. Dina was known throughout the village for her ability to bring comfort at any time of the day or night.
I use my lamp to light my path as I travel to the homes of the villagers during the darkest hours of the night. Because I use my lamp constantly, I worry that I might run out at will on my journeys through the darkness. And so I ask the shopkeeper to create a vessel so I could carry extra oil from my lamp. My lamp has brightened the rooms of those that are sick and warmed the lives of the lonely. It has accompanied me through moments when I have seen sorrow and at times when I have witnessed grief.
Inscribed an intricate floral design across the top of the lamp. The shopkeeper gently placed it in the kiln. Nava knew that her own lamp was something to be treasured, and she carried it everywhere she went.
As I walked home with my lamp, I admired the soft glowing flame and knew this was some gift that needed to be treasured. But keeping the flame lit is a difficult task, one that requires constant attention. And so, although I carry it with me wherever I go, I rarely light my lamp. On special occasions, I do sit down with it at my table. I have to pull the wick through the small hole at the top, trim off the blackened and used portion, and light it so that my lamp will burn bright and true. As I look at the soft, glowing flame, I wonder, I'm my lamp, but I don't light it more often.
Beautiful.
watched Gabriella closely for many years before he finally came up with the perfect design for her lamb. She was an unassuming woman and rarely called attention to herself, which made the task more challenging. She was also gentle and wise beyond her years. Her clothing was unadorned and beautiful in its simplicity. She had a natural style and elegance that were all her own.
Every day, I make my way up the narrow path that leads to the shopkeeper. I'm beginning to realize that spending more time with him will help me to become more like him. He makes me feel welcome every time I visit. And it is my hope that those who visit my home find me to be such a loyal friend as he is, one who always speaks of others with respect and admiration. When the shopkeeper asked what I hoped for, I asked him to make my lamp simple. He molded the clay into an oval that fits perfectly in the palm of my hand. With painstaking care, he smooths away each rough spot and imperfection. My lamp is simple, allowing those who see it to focus on the flame.
How I want.
waiting for her lamp to be made. As the shopkeeper was crafting her lamp, she would often run into the shop, pulling her wind-blown hair back into place, her round brown eyes wide with anticipation.
I visited the shopkeeper every day and watched as he sat at his wooden workbench warming my lamp. I couldn't wait for the moment when it would be done. He often told me how much he appreciated my company and enjoyed our conversations. Now that my lamp is finished, my visits to the shop have become fewer and farther between. The journey up the hill just takes too long. In the morning, I'm too busy, and in the evening, I'm just too tired. But when I'm in desperate need, I do go to him, and each time, the shopkeeper seems so grateful for my visit.
Malka's lamp was hewn from a beautiful piece of soft red sandstone. After the shopkeeper had given her the gift, she looked at it in wonder. She was amazed that the shopkeeper had gone to the effort to make her such a beautiful gift.
When the shopkeeper gave me my lamp, I noticed that the design was very unique. It must have taken him hours to shape and smooth it. I thanked him for the gift and put it carefully in my bag. Sometimes I look at this lamp and can't believe how lucky I am. I'm so flattered that the shopkeeper would have taken the time to make me such a beautiful gift. But none of my friends ever uses her lamp. Besides, I know the village so well, I don't need a light to guide my way. I rarely light it at all. I can see fine through the darkness. But my lamp truly is beautiful, so I set it out at my home as a decoration for friends to admire.
the shopkeeper gave Leora her lamp. He had watched her take the hands of other villagers and by its light lead them through the darkness. He noticed that every time her path met another, she would pause, lift her lamp in front of her, and consider her direction. Because it was hard for Leora to focus in the darkness, the shopkeeper worried that she might become lost when she came to a fork or a bend in the road. He knew that without enough light, she would not be able to find her way.
One afternoon, the shopkeeper cut a long branch from a tree outside his shop and whittled it until it was smooth. Then he crafted a small cup, just large enough for my lamp to fit inside, and attached it to the end of the pole. The shopkeeper must have known that I would treasure this unique gift. On the first evening, after he gave it to me, I lit my lamp and fit it into the cup. I held the lamp high and it lit the entire path. I've noticed as the night grows deeper, the flame grows brighter, allowing me to help the lost, the weary, and the worn find their way back home.
Jessa wasn't sure how it had happened. She woke up one morning to find her lamp in broken pieces on the floor. Perhaps it had blown off the table during the furious winds that had preceded the storm. She was devastated.
I thought my heart had broken. I could barely see through my tears as I picked up the tiny pieces and gently set them on the table. Each time I passed the tiny pile, I closed my eyes and wondered if the heart of God felt inside would ever go away. After many days, I came to accept what I had known all along. There is only one who can fix the lamp. I gathered up the pieces and started up the hill. It wasn't long before the rain came. The path became slippery, and then the downpour came. The wind whipped my hair to my eyes, and it was hard for me to see. When I realized I wasn't going to make it, I cried out for help. In an instant, he was there. The shopkeeper had been walking just below me. He covered me with his warm, heavy cloak, picked me up in his strong, steady arms, and carried me up the hill. After the storm, he sent me down the hill with two gifts:
my restored lamp and grateful heart.
In time, the shopkeeper decided to marry and chose a bride. Each of the 10 women received an invitation to attend the wedding, and each was asked to take part in one of the village's most honored customs. On the night of the wedding, these 10 chosen women would use their lamps to light the doorway of the home where the wedding would be held. The glow from their lamps would bring honor to the groom as he entered the home for the celebration. It was a great privilege to be given this invitation, one that many women waited a lifetime to receive. The women could barely contain their excitement for the events that were about to unfold. And finally, the long-awaited day arrived. The 10 women made their way through the crowded streets of the village to the entry of the home where the wedding would be held. And the shopkeeper watched from the top of the hill and waited. Finally, the 10 chosen women arrived at their destination. Each found a comfortable place in the alcove of the doorway and settled down to wait. Time passed slowly, and growing weary, the women closed their eyes and slept. The 11th hour came and went. The entire village grew quiet under the soft glow of the moon, and still, the shopkeeper watched from the top of the hill and waited. Hour of the night, when a hush had fallen over the sleeping village, those villagers who had patiently waited and watched raised a cry. The silence was broken. The women awoke with a start. The moment was at hand. It was time to trim their lamps. Suddenly alert, Jessa quickly used her extra oil to fill her darkened lamp. A lifetime of waiting had come to an end, and she hoped she had made sufficient preparation. Gabriella reached for her vessel and filled her simple lamp with all of the oil that she had left. As she carefully tucked her empty vessel away, Nava, who was sitting beside her, let out a small cry. Her flame had gone out. Her lamp was empty. She had not brought any extra oil. What would she do now?
I've waited for this night for as long as I can remember. So desperately want to be a part of this wedding. My preparations just weren't enough. Why didn't I think to bring extra oil? That thought never crossed my mind.
Frantic, Nava turned to Gabriella to see if she had extra oil, but there was none to spare. She watched the other women trim their lamps as tears ran down her cheeks and fell on the empty flowered lamp that was cradled in the folds of her dress. Realizing her mistake, Nava fell to the ground weeping. With the bridegroom approaching, the preparations around her intensified, and soon other women in the group realized that they were also short of oil.
I've been so consumed with the daily necessities of life that I kept putting off the trip to the shop on the hill. I just simply ran out of time.
I haven't talked to the shopkeeper in quite a while. The days turned into months until I've lost track. I've waited for this day for such a long time, but I didn't expect him to arrive so late in the evening. I didn't prepare for the delay.
I wondered if there had an idea on me. I considered buying oil, but since I rarely wrapped my room, I thought I might go to waste.
I used my spare money to buy a new dress for the wedding. I wanted to look as nice as the others. I didn't have enough left over to buy more oil.
five women rushed over to Dina and Leora and fell at their feet, begging for help. These women had brightened the darkness for them in the past. Surely they would share their oil. But what had been prepared could not be shared in an instant. Every drop was needed now. As much as they longed to help their friends, there was nothing they could do. Finally, weeping tears of frustration, the five foolish women turned to Eliana. The wise woman could give them nothing but advice.
Go into the dark of the night and get some oil. Buy what you need and hurry and return. The bridegroom is coming.
Clutching their empty hands, the frantic women ran through out the garden gate and into the village streets. They would never make it back in time. The five remaining women carefully trimmed their wicks and finished emptying the oil from their vessels into their lamps. The bridegroom made his way through the crowded streets. He turned the corner just in time to see the five foolish women running toward the hill. His heart ached for them. Then he lifted his eyes to the doorway and took in the sight he had waited a lifetime to see. Leora was there with her finely crafted pole, holding her lamp high. The flame from Gabriella's simple lamp lit up her eyes, which glistened with anticipation. Dina lifted her lamp so the flame could dance with the others, adding a soft glow to the brilliant display of light. Eliana rested a wrinkled hand on Dina's arm and lifted her yellow lamp as high as her frail arm could reach. And quiet Jessa had her lamp cupped in her hands while tears of overwhelming gratitude streamed down her cheeks. These five women had come to know the bridegroom, and their hearts filled with joy as they watched him stride through the garden gate and down the pathway that led to the great wooden door. The shopkeeper paused and greeted each of the women one by one. Then he invited them in for the wedding feast. Together, the five women raised their lamps in a final tribute and went in with him to the marriage.
He lifted me and strengthened me.
He believed in me and encouraged me.
When I was weak, he made me strong.
When I thought I could not go on, he made up the difference.
When I found disappointment, he offered consoling peace.
And at that day, when I shall come in my glory, shall the parable be fulfilled which I spake concerning the 10 virgins. For they that are wise and have received the truth and have taken the Holy Spirit for their guide and have not been deceived, verily I say unto you, they shall not be hewn down and cast into the fire, but shall abide the day. For the Lord shall be in their midst, and his glory shall be upon them.